Hey guys, and welcome to my little tutorial or talk about where I talk about this denim jacket that I've painted. This is unscripted. I figured I wanted to do something with these videos that I've been recording over on Twitch and put them somewhere, and I thought that YouTube is probably the best place for it. Anyway, this is me drawing guts from Berserk on the back of a denim jacket, and I wanted to talk about the process. Here I am sketching in a white pastel charcoal situation on the back of the jacket. Everything's kind of taped off where I really don't want paint to be going, and I'm sort of just blocking out the shapes of the face and planning where I want things. I mess up multiple times and like change my mind about where I want, what I want, and you know, just laying out the armor and the background and planning out, really like blocking and contrast, etc., is really the plan here. I do really enjoy how this jacket came out, and I hope that you guys like the result and maybe can learn something from watching this sped up process. I have been trying to figure out ways to post these little videos that I do on Twitch somehow to YouTube, different formats. I really didn't know which format I wanted to do. I ended up settling, I think, with speed paints and kind of talk overs of my speed paints. As you could see, me moving around at 8x speed is not me talking right now. This is much later. I've actually painted an entirely other jacket after doing this one as a commission, because I liked how much this one came out. I decided to open up jacket commissions. Here I'm grabbing all my paint. I want to talk about my paints. Okay, if you're planning on doing this kind of thing, I really, really, really suggest having a lot of white acrylic on you. And that is for one big reason. You are going to be blocking in basically the entire thing in white acrylic. I did this very sloppily with this jacket, and that I regret. I also regret maybe my sketch was too detailed and I didn't want to lose a lot of that. I didn't trust myself enough, I think, and ended up not using as much white as I would have liked. It's one of the biggest mistakes that I made with this jacket, and when you are painting a denim jacket, I strongly advise laying down white paint everywhere. I also tried using Posca, and to be honest, Posca helps much in the late game. As you could see, it's a little bit watery, I guess. That would be the word, opaque? Or is opaque when it's thickly on, or was that when it's see-through? I don't know. Whichever the one is, the transparent. I don't trust the Posca right away. I would stick with the paint right away. Use a good acrylic, especially. I wouldn't go with a student-grade white acrylic. I would say student-grade is okay for the rest of the paint on the jacket, but when it comes to the white, I would really go with a professional-grade acrylic paint. The difference between student grade and professional grade acrylic is that student grade contains less pigment, less of the stuff that makes it colorful in it, and more of the medium, the gloss or matte medium in it, and thus you get a less vibrant color. I learned this the hard way in college using cheap paints. I didn't really realize why they were cheap until my professor was like, oh yes, you probably want to be using professional paint, because that's why you're losing so much color, and that's why it's taking so many coats. And in the meantime, you could be doing everything in one coat with a professional grade paint. Anyway, back to talking about this jacket. I am blocking in a ton of white, and I did not block in white everywhere, if I recall, and that was a mistake. I also still want to talk a little bit about Twitch, because I figured I'd just talk through this entire video of me painting, which is so long. I'll probably take some pauses. But I wanted to talk a little bit about Twitch. I stream on Twitch frequently. I don't want to say my stream schedule, because what if it changes? But as of, what day is it? Wednesday, April 8th, 2020. I stream every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Saturday. Sometime after 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, I usually stream a little bit later than that because I'm always so busy or eating dinner or something dumb comes in the way of me getting on stream. But I do pretty much all art on stream, traditional and digital, and for a long time didn't really know what to do with the content when it came to YouTube. I have done YouTube before. I had a YouTube channel before this that I guess I posted on frequently enough in high school. It became really hard to post in high school on my other YouTube channel. And I'm not going to say the name of the YouTube channel. I don't want people to find it. and I gave up, and I switched to Twitch for art, and here I am, and now I'm back on YouTube somehow. I hope that this time-lapse format is good for YouTube, and I hope that people, you know, would like to see this kind of thing from me. My streams are much more chaotic than something like me talking into a microphone about what my process was when painting this. But if you would like to see me hectically work, a lot of the times I get really frustrated and I freak out. A lot of the times I'm confident and very cocky about what I'm doing. It's like a big adventure on Twitch, and God knows what's gonna happen every day. I usually don't know what I'm doing with my stuff. But if you're interested in that kind of thing, I will leave the link below, of course. I think here I'm realizing a little bit, and I think I totally realized it here. The white, of course, is very messy. And I think right about here I started freaking out. As you can see, I started laying in my grays. And kind of realizing the nuances of painting on denim. And there's a lot of them. Number one, it's almost impossible to really blend, or at least that's how I found it. I'm sure if I handed denim to my painting professor, he would probably be able to paint this gorgeous, realistically rendered portrait on it. But for me, I found the best way to paint on denim is to simply block everything out. Very print-like. As if you're making a print, you know, like from a block, linoleum, etc. Kind of sketch everything out and paint everything like that. I found that to be the most helpful. And I used that method kind of at the end, and I used it a lot on the next jacket that I ended up doing. If this video does well, maybe I'll edit the footage of that jacket and post it here, but I figured this would be a more interesting video because I could talk about my mistakes. And also, Guts is a very cool character, and there's a new Berserk chapter coming out this month, and I thought this is like the perfect time to be posting a speed paint of Guts on YouTube. Because, you know, who doesn't love him? The grays that I'm using here are student grade gray paint. It was not easy to use at all. The amount of coats that I had to end up doing with the grays was obnoxious, and on camera it is just so impossible to tell what's going on. And I have this issue a lot with my stream, is that my camera is very good, but the color, it being able to pick up certain colors and the certain mistakes and issues within my piece make it hard. And sometimes it picks up things that don't show up in real life, like the highlights in the paint that kind of make a lot of the black paint look very gray and white in the light, because of the ring light doesn't show up in real life. And I'll post the real pictures of the end results of the jacket, if you will, in the video somewhere. But if you follow me on Instagram, you might have already seen the jacket and noticed that it looks very different than it did on stream and now here on YouTube. Just because that is the way that my camera works, and if I end up posting future speed paints, you'll also see that it, and this is black and white of course, but anything that I do in color looks just off, very off, and I can't really figure out how to fix that. In the background behind Guts here, I think it's a little bit hard to make out, but I have this, his cape is kind of coming around in the back, and well, it's not, is it a cape? It is, it's a cape cloak situation that I think he wears, and I don't know how it hasn't been torn to shreds yet in battle, but it hasn't. But I drew his little cape cloak thing in the background. It caused me some problems, mind you, but I think it looked good in the end. Here I'm also coming in with Posca, which I have to say, this is the time to come in with Posca, is after you have everything you want really laid out kind of in a good kind of way. And I'm really only halfway through painting this thing here, and I don't think I realize that now, but Posca is a good thing to use for those nooks and crannies and smoothing out lines. I found that the white Posca didn't really work that well, no matter what, though. And here I'm beginning to realize that the fault in the white Posca paint pens. However, the black, here's me using the black, was marvelous. I have to say, black Posca pens, and I've used them on Duralar before, so I had faith before this, and this just kind of sealed the nail in the coffin, that the black Posca pen is a god tier paint pen. It's like the best thing, that, and also, right on the hair, as you can see, don't use the Posca pen until the paint is dry already, okay? Stop rushing it like I did. I rush my work a lot because I'm working on stream. I like my viewers to see start to finish my work, and I don't want them to, like, you know, have gaps in time, but it happens a lot. So here I'm kind of just like moving along, keep going. I made the eyebrows very thick on Guts because I don't know. I always draw eyebrows very thick. Don't judge, please. I was actually wearing this jacket. Yeah, I tried to fix the thickness of the eyebrow by making it come into the eye. It looks kind of sick, not gonna lie. But I wore this jacket the other day here in Corona quarantine land on my walk. Plenty of people commented on it, like, all the time. They're like, oh, you painted that? And I'm like, yes, I did paint this. I painted this. Thank you. I get a lot of compliments on it, so if you're looking for compliments in life, I strongly advise painting a jacket. Obviously, as you could see on my phone, in the little corner of the screen there, I'm flashing my reference by accident. It's fine. It's not like I didn't use reference for this. It's, I think, a pretty famous panel from Berserk that I referenced a little bit, and then I referenced some other panels and tried to get just the general look of him down. I made him a little bit younger than he actually is. I think I have a big issue drawing older guys. Like, a huge issue. I have a hard time drawing men, and then I have a hard time drawing older men especially, and I don't think I've ever tried to draw many older women, so that's the tea, I guess. Here on my tape is wrinkling. You could probably already see it, but the red went on brilliantly, and I think that's because it's my professor's red paint, and it's like the best quality that you could probably get, and he let me borrow his paint, and then I never returned it because he said to keep it. And I also used that red Posca pen. It worked pretty well. Posca's okay on denim. I was unsure about it, and then I read online about red Posca, not red Posca, but just Posca paint in general online. I read about it to make sure, like, is this okay to use on fabric? And I knew that acrylic would be okay, and Posca is acrylic, but God knows what Posca, what's in the pens, really. Like, it's a kind of a mystery how these things work, I feel, but it worked out fine. Went on the coat, hasn't come off, and I use that black Posca pen religiously now on fabrics, especially. It is just so perfect for hiding mistakes, and it is so perfect at just a bold outline, like, at the eye, worked so well. The cross hatching came out, you know, and I think it worked out in a way that I didn't expect the black to work out, and that was cool. And I really liked that pen. I really enjoy that pen. If you're looking for a black acrylic pen, Posca's the way to go, apparently. They're kind of pricey, though, I have to say. Just a little bit too pricey. I'm sure that there's a way to probably make a black paint pen, and if you want to shoot for that, you could shoot for that. Here I'm kind of just adding the details and finishing touches on the jacket, trying to thicken up that red, because once again it's like impossible to see that it's not perfect up there for some reason. But I think it's coming out well. I splattered red blood paint on it for the bloody look. And I think I'm kind of just finishing this up here, just letting it be. It looks weird on camera still, and I think here's when I probably declared it. Yeah. After this, you just tear off the tape. I fixed up the red in the corners, and I called it a day. So that's that beautiful Berserk jacket on my tiny, tiny table. I somehow painted a jacket on the tiny table. At this point, I did realize that there was stuff wrong with the hair. I accidentally gave him a mullet here, I realize. I fixed that, I think. You know, fiddling around with the hair, I started to see the kind of the failures up there, but all in all, it was pretty much done at this point. And just cleaning up. And if I ever want to fix it again, I could just paint on it again. I'd like to talk a little bit about the heat sealing. I just used an iron after the paint dried on the inside of the jacket to seal it in the heat. And it came out well. It hasn't rained on it yet, so I don't know. But other than that, I think that it came out really good. And I couldn't have asked for a better denim jacket to wear around. I used my hair dryer a lot to dry up the jacket. And it looks sick on the back, I have to say. But for heat, I totally want to talk about heat sealing in more detail. For heat sealing and about washing, because I'm about to start working on the sleeve and the pocket I also did of this jacket here. When it comes to heat sealing, I used an iron and I turned the jacket inside out. I put a little bit of parchment on the side of the paints and I just ironed it on a high heat, making sure not to stay in one place at a time and constantly checking to make sure that the paint wasn't like melting or anything, and thank God it didn't. I've seen people like throw their jackets and pants and whatever into the oven. I don't really know how I feel about the oven situation. I don't know if I would necessarily put something into an oven, like a jacket, but if that's how you want to do it, then do it. Look at how tiny my table is. Okay, so I just ordered a new table online recently. It's coming in this week, and I have two more jacket commissions to do, and I'm ready. I just want the table to come in. It's the table that I'm working on here is about, I have to say, like 3 feet across, like where my cutting board is, like across. And then it's about only a foot and a half deep. And it's terrible. It's just so small. The amount of space that a painting takes up on that table is ridiculous. Here I'm painting, Guts's sword, the big raw heap of iron. I just love it. I painted it in red. I felt like if I was gonna use red in the pack, I might as well use some more red, and it was pretty fairly quick to do. The white pastel that you see coming through the painting, you might even see it on the back still here in these shots, but you could kind of, after you heat set the jacket, I would just like try to wash it out with a little bit of a washcloth, a cold washcloth, and try to just wipe it away. It should come away. It's just white pastel, so it mixes with the paint just fine and you don't notice it when you're painting. It's way better than using like pencil. And it comes out with water, just a little bit of water. That black Posca pen here came in clutch, by the way, it really did. And I still don't know if the sword is like even or not when it comes to a rectangle. but it looks pretty fine, and my sleeves are rolled up a lot, so it's kind of hard to see. But it feels good to wear, and it looks good, and I haven't really had any cracking yet. That was a big worry of mine, was that the paint would end up cracking. It hasn't been too long since I've worn this jacket. The first time, I've been wearing it pretty frequently to go out. If I ever want looking to impress, I wear it because then people want to talk about it, like, what's going on? You're such a punk rocker. What's up with the jacket? And haven't had too much cracking. I do roll up that sleeve with the sword on it, and I haven't seen it crack at all. I just wore it again, what was that, yesterday and today, I think. No cracking yet. Here I'm working on the brand of the sufferer that Guts has and Casca has on them. And I thought, you know, I have to include something on the pocket, and it has to be the brand. I was thinking about doing the egg on the pocket, but then I was like, I don't know. I think it's brand time. Also, the egg is like complicated, and at this point, I think I was pretty damn tired. And I'm happy that I picked the brand, because the egg, I think, would have just been pretty messy if I had tried it. Here I'm working in that red Posca, and you know, it didn't work out too poorly. The red Posca went on fine after I had a normal amount of red and black paint on to begin with. I don't know what I'm reading on my phone. Don't ask. But at this point, everything's pretty much done. And just some words of caution is to make sure that you heat set, and if you're going to wash anything, I strongly suggest hand washing and making sure that it's only with cold water. Absolutely. You know, you don't want to be using any sort of hot water whatsoever. I'm going to test out washing this thing in the washing machine. I know I live on the edge, but I don't fit into the jacket completely. I've gained a little bit of, I'm gonna say muscle because I'm cocky enough to say it, but I haven't washed it since painting on it, because it's a denim jacket. You know, you don't always wash your jackets like every time you wear them. But I want to try tossing it into the washing machine on cold and on delicate and completely alone. And I will probably update you guys on how that turns out. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed listening to me ramble scriptlessly about this jacket that I painted on. I hope that maybe you learned something, or maybe you just enjoyed listening to my silly voice. I'm kind of unsure about these videos that I'm going to be making on YouTube, so please, if you're watching, and I know the channel is very small right now, so I doubt not that many people are watching, but if you are watching, please leave a comment. Let me know what you liked or what you didn't like. That way, for the next video, I can adjust and change things and make things better and see, you know, what I should add. Maybe you guys want a more quiet, contemplative type video with a little bit more ambience and music and stuff and less of me talking. Or maybe you guys really do want me to talk the entire time. I don't know. Let me know. Anyway, I hope that you guys enjoyed it, and I hope that you guys enjoyed how the jacket came out and don't think I'm crazy for posting it, you know. Read Berserk. It's a great manga, a fantastic. Don't watch the anime unless you've read the manga first, and don't watch the Netflix anime at all. Thanks for watching, guys.